Did you hear that echo reverb at the end of that music track? Well, that was not the natural ending. I actually applied an effect, and let me show you how it works inside of Premiere. So first, I'm going to add a default transition at the end just by right-clicking on it or control-clicking and selecting Apply Default Transition. And let me just stretch this out a little bit and play it back. So it just naturally fades out, but there's nothing wow about that. There's nothing exciting about that. So I'm going to delete that. And what we're going to do is cut out the part that we want to echo. So if I just play this back here. So that last ooh, that's what I'm going to apply the echo to. So I'm just going to go in here and cut out that ooh just by moving my playhead. Pressing C on my keyboard and cutting, and also cutting right here at the end, just like that. And then I'll delete this part here. All right, so now that it's cut, what we need to do is bring it down to audio track one. Because we're going to be applying this effect at the track level, we don't want the entire echo to affect all of the audio in audio track one. So you can just click to drag down or press option and arrow key down to move that clip down. Now we're going to go up to the audio track mixer. And if you don't see this gray area here, make sure that you click on this caret. And audio track two, which is the second one here, we're going to apply a reverb effect, the studio reverb. So just with the default settings, let's play it back and see what happens. See how it stops at the end there? Well, actually, the track needs more information after this point, so that way the echo can continue on. Now, if you have a video clip above, you can stretch this out if you need to. What you can also do is create a black video by going to this little new item and create black video or transparent video. Or another option is you can take this audio clip, press option to duplicate it and drag it up, and then you can control click on it and disable it. So it's just empty audio, but at least it's here and you can extend this out for however long you want that echo to be. So now let's play it back and you'll hear that the echo continues. So now we can adjust the studio reverb. So to go to the effect settings, go up to studio reverb, it double click on it. And here we can play around with some of the parameters. There's a bunch of different presets that you can play around with, but we can decrease the decay so that way it echoes on longer. We can also increase the wetness a bit. And now let's play it back. You'll also notice that you hear just a little tiny click at the very end here. What we can do is add the default transition and just make it a very small transition. So right click on this, apply default, and then adjust the constant power just to the end so that little click is gone. And let's play it back. Now it's smooth. And by the way, my name is Kelsey and welcome back to Gal. According to my YouTube analytics, not a lot of you are subscribed. And if this video is helping you out, be sure to hit that subscribe button right now, as well as that notification bell so you're notified when I publish more tips just like this. And this video is sponsored by Epidemic Sound. The music and sound effects I'm using in this video was provided by Epidemic. And the great thing about Epidemic is that it's a subscription. So you pay monthly and you can use unlimited tracks. So you can access really high quality music that you can use in any type of video, whether it's for your social media or for your commercial. There's also sound effects as well. And if you go to Epidemic and you search Premiere Gal, you can find my Premiere Gal Editing Essentials list where I put together some of my favorite background music that goes great with video. You can use my affiliate link just down below to get 30 days free of Epidemic, so you can download as much as you want and use them in your videos to see if it works great. It certainly helps improve my sound in my videos. All right, that's all for Epidemic, and let's go ahead and jump back into the video. Now you may be wondering, why are we applying the effect at the track level and not directly on the clip? Because you can go into effects and you can search for studio reverb and apply it to the clip. But when you apply it just to the clip, there's no space for it to echo. And that's why you need to apply to the track level so you can add a handle and the echo can continue. So that's why we chose to work with the audio track mixer itself. Now there's just one more thing that we can do. Notice how it just kind of cuts off there. So if we play it back, you'll hear that it's not just like a gradual fade out. Let me just play it again. What we can do is we can make adjustments to the volume of the track level itself. So right now you can see underneath audio track 2, if you make it bigger, if it's too small, you won't be able to see this, but if you make it bigger, you'll see a keyframe here. And normally it's the clip keyframes, but let's go into track keyframes, volume. So you can actually keyframe the volume of the entire track. So at this point we can press P and create a point, and at the end here, create another point, and then drag this down. And then it will gradually fade out. So let me play this back. And there we go. It sounds great. To add some more dynamism, I'm adding some sound effects to my video. So what I did is I went into search on Epidemic, and I searched under sound effects for sci-fi. And I downloaded a bunch of different, you know, digital effects. They have these beeps, some whooshes, so much that you can do with it. And so inside of Premiere, I created my updated timeline here where I placed in these sound effects here. The reason why I added these sound effects is here I added this flash transition that looks like almost like a solar flare. And here I added another glitch transition and added this glitch sound effect from Epidemic Sound just to bring it together. And those transitions are from Film Impact. I highly recommend Film Impact. It's really easy drag and drop transitions, and I'll put a discount code up here that you can use if you're interested in trying that out. And then for this moment here, I actually just keyframed. So if I go into Effect Controls, I just keyframed the scale to go from 120 all the way down to zero. So the astronaut just disappears with this whoosh effect. All right, so that's kind of breaking down what I did. So adding all of these sound effects and placing them in the correct spot is one thing, but then mixing them together at the correct level is another. And Premiere Pro's Essential Sound Panel actually makes it really easy to do. So for example, let me just play back this part with the glitch so you can hear how loud the glitch sound effect is and how we need to fix that. So let's play this back. See how the sound effect just sounds a little bit too high for the music? So what we're going to do is lasso and select all four of these clips at the same time. So click and just drag out this lasso so all four of them are selected. Then go to Essential Sound and select Sound Effects. And then we can select Auto Match. And see how the audio waveforms just went a little bit smaller? That's because it's normalizing it for the broadcast standard. And then we can add some cool reverb. So underneath Creative, just select Reverb. And you can choose from different presets, heavy, light, outside, or room. But all that this did, if we, for example, just select this glitch sound effect here and we go up to Effect Controls here, all it did was apply a studio reverb effect just like we did before at the track level, but this time on the clip itself. All right, so let's play back the final video with all of the sounds and the reverb effects applied. So that's all for creating this echo reverb effect at the track level as well as at the individual clip level. If this video helped you out, be sure to click my face right over here to subscribe. And if you want to learn more about sound mixing and how to make your dialogue sound better, you can click here to watch this free course here on YouTube that I created. And that's all for today's video. As always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.